Hello and welcome to this PREEvision tutorial. My name is Marcus, I'm a technical writer at Vector, and I want to show you how you can use diagrams for modeling. PREEvision provides many different diagrams. Here you can see a composition of software components. This example is a hardware network of ECUs connected by bus systems. The different diagrams all work with the same basic concepts, and I want to explain you the most important of these concepts now. In this example, I create a network diagram in the hardware architecture. I'm asked to enter a name for the diagram, and the diagram opens automatically. The basic tool for modeling is the palette on the right. Here, you find all the artifacts that you can create in the diagram. I want to create an ECU, so I select ECU. With a second click, I add the ECU to the diagram. Another means for modeling is the pop-up bar. It can be activated in the diagram toolbar. The tools of the palette and the pop-up bar are basically the same, but the pop-up bar provides the most commonly used tools that can be used in the selected context. When I select the ECU, I can create a bus connector. When I select the bus connector, I can create a connection to the other ECU. What is important to understand: a diagram can only show content that exists in the model. However, not all artifacts in the model are shown in all the relevant diagrams. So be careful when you want to get rid of something in your diagram. You can either remove it from the diagram, the artifact then still exists in the model, or you can delete it completely, both in the diagram and in the model itself. The diagram framework is trying to support you while modeling. For example, it displays the possible targets for a connection. Via tap, I can step through the connections and select one with return. Another example: if the routing gets a bit messy, you can clean it up with this button that recalculates the routings. One last example: you find toolbar buttons to resize or to align artifacts. The reference is always the last selected artifact. Explore the toolbar to find more helpful features. You may have noticed that everything we've done until now is happening in the package that contains the diagram, but you can also enrich the diagram by relating or referencing artifacts that exist outside this context. For example, you can assign a bus connector type to the bus connectors simply by drag and drop, or you can map a software composition to an ECU. And again, PREEvision helps you by creating an additional artifact you need for the mapping. Explore the features in the tool or find tips and tricks for diagrams via this toolbar button, or find detailed descriptions of all diagram features in the PREEvision user manual. I hope this video gives you some ideas how you can utilize diagrams for your purposes and helps you to start modeling right away.